It's certainly not been a very friendly place for Clemson over the past several years. They have lost 15 consecutive games in Lawrence Joel Coliseum, and that is something that Oliver Purnell hopes to change tonight. Oliver Purnell, in his fourth season as the Clemson head coach, he has improved upon the number of wins every year here at Clemson, from 10 to 16 to 19. And he's been coach of the year in three different conferences as well, hoping he can add the ACC to that resume by the conclusion of play this season. Brian Kersey, Gary Maxwell, Curtis Blair, the officials. We are underway from Winston-Salem, the Tigers controlling the opening tip. Hamilton with the basketball. He actually ran back into the hotel, Bucky, when I was coming over here, and had left his wallet in his hotel room. Hopefully he's not rattled tonight on the court.
But Ishmael Smith is going to be unhappy about that, because he was figuring on taking that, hubcaps, fillings, everything. This is his first encounter with the great senior guard.
Wake Forest on offense for the first time. Three freshmen in that starting lineup. It was the 10th best freshman class coming in college basketball this year. And a bad shot put up by Skeen. Hamilton. So no one's in a bucket. We've had three shots. Pace is pretty quick. This is Smith, the freshman point guard. Three-pointer on the way, no good by Hale.
Hey, Wake Forest, don't forget about Fisher down there. He's your best player.
Mays, in our Star Watch feature, scores the first bucket of the night for Clemson. James Mays, a 6'9 junior from nearby Garner, North Carolina. And here come the Demon Deacons. Visser touching it, and both of our Star Watch players scoring for each team.
Sam, see, I can still coach. They must have heard me.
Nobody ever doubted that. Well, we do have a direct feed to the bench, right?
They just fall in love with that quick three. They get excited. Young teams do that, but they got to go to the man.
Mays with all the Tiger points so far. 4-2, 18-20 left, and full court pressure being applied by Clemson. Smith. Lightning quick dish to Visser, misses the shot. That's been one of the frustrations this year for Wake Forest. Smith has given off great assists, and guys have just missed shots for Wake Forest.
Boy, he can fly, and he takes the ball with him.
Turnover for Clemson. And Visser missing that layup, saying, my fault. Here's the nice pass from the freshman.
Ooh, just couldn't get it over the rim. Visser was a guy that had great fits and starts early in his career. Never could sustain it, but he really worked hard prior to his senior year. Went to Pete Newell's big man camp. Really paid his dues, and it's paid off for him. What a marvelous senior year.
Put on about 10 pounds of muscle in the offseason as well. He'd been playing behind Eric Williams. Steal by one of the best defensive players in the ACC, Hammonds. Or that's Hammonds shooting the three. Excuse me. Hamilton made the steal. And Hammonds knocks down the first three-pointer. They're the co-captains as they team up for the tray here as Clemson takes a 7-2 lead.
And every time that Clemson scores, it has a chance to set up that trap, which is a nightmare if your guards are fragile. Got to come to meet the pass, Wake Forest, especially against the quickness of Clemson. Wham! That's perfect. Quick cross-court pass. Big men were under. Boards were covered. That was a legit open three.
Clemson forcing another turnover, and you see early on Clemson 3 of 5, Wake Forest struggling, shooting 1 of 4. Just about every offensive category has been a struggle for Wake this year. Rivers, one of the best players on this Clemson team, comes off the bench. He's arguably the best sixth man in the country. A whole new crew out here for Clemson. That is Potter missing the shot.
Almost missed everything.
Potter out of Florida. Smith on the drive, and he's fouled on the way to the basket. Hammonds a little late in guarding Smith, and Hammonds gets picked up for the first foul, so we'll see our first free throw of the night.
Sadly, Ishmael Smith is a 43% free throw shooter, and that's hard to explain.
Well, free throw shooting is not something either of these teams does well this year. They are 11th and 12th in the ACC in that category, though Smith calmly knocks down the first one. Smith second in the ACC in assists. As you see, he averages at 5.7 a game, coming off a 6-assist game against North Carolina. Knocks down both free throws here.
Six assists, six boards, and 6 points against the Tar Heels. The Deacons actually led midway through the first half, 23-22, and then the Tar Heels just took them apart. The rest of that game was an autopsy.
Yeah, 104-67. It was the worst loss suffered by a Skip Prosser team since he's been here at Wake Forest. Hale will try another three off the mark again, and there's the athleticism of Jamie Skeen, one of the most highly touted freshmen coming in here this year, making an immediate impact, averaging 7 points and 5 rebounds a game. Wake within one.
Again, very important for a young, insecure team to get a good start.
Hammonds off the mark on the three. And the battle for the rebound will result in Wake Forest getting possession. 16 minutes left to play in the opening half as substitutions coming into the game for both teams. Wholesale substitutions. Clemson's been going about 9 deep. Wake Forest has been using several rotations lately, just trying to find something that is going to work as we head into the end of the regular season. Wake Forest has got a heck of a streak going, Bucky. They've been to the postseason the last 16 years, and that is very much on the line right now.
Well, this time, and fortunately, the Atlantic Coast Conference, everybody makes the tournament. Nice looking wide open three. Skeen looking very confident out there.
Yeah, we saw him.
Rookie.
We saw him with the dunk earlier. It's the three-pointer now. And Wake Forest with the lead, but it is a short-lived lead as the layup makes it 9-9. LB Williams. Williams fouled, it's 9-9. Wake Forest making a run behind Jamie Skeen's hot play. We'll be right back.
Wrestling, Navy versus Army, Sunday at 8:30 p.m. on ESPNU.
Odds of being involved in a movie-style car crash.
And cut.
One in a billion. Odds of you being in a crash. One in eight. It's why Allstate created accident forgiveness. Now your rates won't go up just because of an accident. Part of your choice auto, only from Allstate. It's time to make the world a better place to drive. That's Allstate, Stan. Are you in good hands?
Honey, I think I found the problem.
Want an easy way to keep your engine clean? Use Conoco Phillips 66 and 76 Quality Pro Clean gasolines. They meet the tough standards to help keep your engine running its best. Conoco Phillips 66 and 76 Quality Pro Clean gasolines.
I'm Martrice.
And I'm Deborah.
We're sisters.
The hole in the wall started out a small little hole.
Ended up huge.
Somebody at Home Depot told me, yeah, you can do this.
They tell you step by step what you need to do.
They're so helpful and knowledgeable and patient.
I wouldn't have been able to finish that project without the people at the Home Depot.
Now my kids say, my mother did that, but.
At first we was like, Ma, you messing up the house. After the fact, it was really nice.
This was a building that we've made into our home.
Wake Forest in the midst of a 7-2 run with 15:25 left to play in the first half. Got a play here Bucky wants to break down for us. What do you call this, Buck?
This is pick and pop. Ishmael, number 10, Ishmael Smith, using the pick. And Jamie Skeen, the 6'8 freshman, instead of rolling, steps back, takes the perfect pass, and drills it. He was lonelier than a hitchhiker with pets, man. There wasn't anybody near him.
Wake Forest led by Skip Prosser. We haven't shown you much of him yet tonight. Skip Prosser in his sixth season. And Wake Forest ninth. Ninth highest winning percentage in ACC history. He was this league's coach of the year back in 2003. Has guided Wake to its first ever national number one ranking. That was a couple of years ago.
He's a Pittsburgh guy, Sam. He a heck of a coach wherever he's been.
LD Williams making the free throw. Skip Prosser One of those guys that's just a blue-collar coach, you know? Yeah. He comes here, he makes his kids work, they graduate. Every senior that's ever played for Skip Prosser's received his degree here in Wake Forest.
Amen and amen. Football team, I think, parallels those statistics as far as graduation, and that makes winning all the more satisfying.
The Deacons up by two. Hamilton on the way to the basket, fouled, and he is fouled by David Weaver. Weaver, a redshirt freshman from Black Mountain, North Carolina, with the same high school as Brad Daugherty.
You know, Brad Daugherty, every time I see him, he's with NASCAR.
Yeah.
I miss him here in Hoops. I thought he did a terrific job for us at ESPN in Hoops. And I just want to see him get in one of those cars. That's what I think.
Something about that sport, when it bites you, you are hooked. Clemson trying to tie or take the lead. This is Rivers. His first shot is no good. And Sykes comes over, knocks it out of bounds. So Wake Forest is going to have a chance to build on its lead.
Again, with a dead ball situation, the Tigers extend their defense, trying to exploit a young, insecure backcourt. Talent, yeah, but sometimes they don't know where it's going, like right there.
Knocked out of bounds, fortunately for Smith, as it was just touched. So Wake Forest will keep it. And Skip Prosser says he likes this team, though. He's really happy with how hard they work. And starting three freshmen, you're just going to have some problems like they've had this year. Smith off the glass, misses the rim. Rebounded by Hammonds.
Kyle, this has been sitting down there a long time. I know the pace of this game has been frantic, but Deacons miss him.
Visser actually fouled out against North Carolina Saturday. Only the third time in his career he's fouled out. Hammonds with the jumper. It's good. A three-pointer as he was just in front of the Wake Forest bench. So Hammonds with 2 3-pointers. He has 6 points, and Clemson back on top by one. Michael Drum.
Very unselfish, Sam. Looks like right now the Deacons trying to settle down, run some half-court offense, and keep Clemson on defense for a while. It's been a chuck and duck affair for both teams.
One of the freshmen, LD Williams, will go to the free throw line, and here is a look at the youth of Wake Forest that Skip Prosser's had to deal with this year. 7 freshmen, 7 sophomores, only 2 seniors on the roster, Michael Drum and Kyle Visser. So that is one of the nation's youngest teams.
That's Skipper's Daycare Center. And they will aid you.
Well, it seems like it's been a pretty constant theme in the ACC this year. And all across the country, really. We've talked about a lot of the young teams in the league and nationally. And if we just look at UConn on the national scene this year, they're having to do a lot of adjustments as well. Williams looking very good from the free throw line. He's made 4 free throws, and he is keeping Wake Forest in front by 1.
Wake Forest now in a 1-3-1. A little, giving them a little medicine of their own. NC State in a 1-3-1 really, really took the Deacons apart in here in January. Just destroyed them. It was 50-32 at the half.
Smith on the drive to Drum, one of those 2 seniors we talked about. He actually gave up his starting spot earlier this year, went to Coach Prosser and said, Coach, look, if I'm starting because I'm a senior and there's guys you'd rather have out there for the future, take my spot.
Wow. And you could use him in the United Nations.
Offensive foul called against the Demon Deacons. Gary Maxwell got someone over there. And it's going to be on Kevin Swinton, number 23. And here's the bad screen here. Swinton got tangled up with Perry and got called for the foul. Well, Ishmael Smith heading to the bench. I'm sure he'll be on that ACC all-freshman team this year. Approaching 13 minutes left in the opening half. This one's been tight, as both of these games last year were tight. They both went to overtime on each other's floor with the home team winning each. Good rebound. Dukes on the drive. Goaltending by Mays, so Joe Dukes is going to get credit for the bucket.
I don't know where Mays came from, but he was flying. Always, too, you should use that inside hand, the one closest to the rim when you're making that block. Otherwise, you put your body in a collision course. That time he evaded the foul, but that was an awesome, awesome display of athleticism.
Visser back in for Wake Forest. See what his presence means now. Visser immediately scored to start the game, but as Bucky mentioned a minute ago, has been on the bench a lot of this first half so far. Hamilton to Perry. Perry on the drive scores. He's the emotional leader of this Clemson team. Very animated young man. And the Tigers within one.
He's a defensive specialist. That's what they call him. But boy, the 6'5 junior from Greenville, what a great first step he showed us there. He just blew by the defense.
Back and forth we go here in Winston-Salem. Clemson searching for its 20th win of the year, trying to get in the top half of the ACC. Gurley driving to the basket, underhands it in with two on the shot clock.
Oliver Purnell just shaking his head. I mean, that was no thing of beauty coming down the lane. And normally when you go down through that paint against Clemson, it's a full body massage. Nobody touched him.
A walking violation called against Perry. Wake Forest leading by three. This is the second season they have had to deal without this young man, Chris Paul. And when we come back, we'll show you exactly what that means statistically.
Every offseason, you start all over.
Nike Shox A-Rod, only at Dick's Sporting Goods.
The Indianapolis Colts have won their first Super Bowl.
He scores! Touchdown!
Relive all the thrills with Sports Illustrated and this must-have NFL Films DVD, The Indianapolis Colts Super Bowl 41 Champions. Plus, this hardcover commemorative book captures the Colts' incredible season through SI's famous writing and photography. Go to SIIndieOffer.com or call now to get both free with your paid subscription to SI. 56 issues for only $1.75 an issue. Save over 55% off the cover price. Use your credit card and get this collectible football honoring the champion Colts. Designed exclusively for Sports Illustrated, it features scores from the entire season and includes a display stamp and certificate of authenticity. Celebrate the Colts' unforgettable victory with the official Super Bowl DVD, the SI commemorative book, and the exclusive football. This limited championship package is only available from Sports Illustrated. Go to SIIndieOffer.com or call right now.
Wake Forest leading by 3 points, shooting 50% so far in the first half. And we showed you Chris Paul going into that last commercial break, and it's time to look back a little more specifically. Chris Paul was in a Wake Forest uniform 2 years ago. He's making a heck of a living now playing professional basketball. This is the second season they've had to live without him, Bucky.
A guy like that spoils you. I know as a coach, when you don't know what to do, you give the ball to Chris Paul or Art Heyman or whomever out there, and they make the plays for you.
Chris Paul.
Yeah, for Clemson, their big bugaboo has been rebounding in seven straight games now. Oliver Purnell just don't know where his rebounding went, and so far that trend has continued. At this juncture, 4 for Clemson, 9 for Wake.
Chris Paul played for Skip Prosser, and he's got another great freshman point guard he's very happy with now, Ishmael Smith. Smith is second in the league in ACC. Chris Paul led the ACC in assists before he left here at Wake Forest. But he says the big difference is everybody Chris Paul was throwing to had an ACC championship ring on his finger. Blocked by the Tigers and a turnover for Wake Forest as Clemson will bring it back up the floor, looking to tie, trailing by 3.
I think somebody back there in Shakespeare time said the passee and the passer. And when the passee can score, it make you look good.
Hamilton puts up a 3. It's good.
How did he get so open?
Vern Hamilton, senior from Richmond. And he deadlocks us at 17. Dukes again commits the turnover. So turnovers starting to mount up for Wake Forest as they get it back. College basketball on ESPNU continues later tonight with a Big East showdown as the Cincinnati Bearcats face Curtis Sumter and the Villanova Wildcats. College basketball on ESPNU tonight at 9 Eastern. For more information, go to ESPNU.com.
Jay Wright coaching the Wildcats, former assistant to Rolly Massimino at Villanova in Las Vegas, doing a terrific job. Made a little stop there in Hofstra, and he's now firmly established in Philadelphia. He's always had good guards, and if you got good guards in college, you are competitive.
Well, certainly Clemson has good guards. There's three of them on the floor now, Rivers, Hamilton, and Hammonds. And that's the big difference for Oliver Purnell, he says, this year to get to the NCAA tournament, as he finally has solid guard play on this Tiger squad. Rivers again will shoot. He's missed two in a row on this possession, but they'll keep firing. Hamilton. Boy, Clemson just can't find the bottom of the net right now.
And the Deacons can't hold them to one shot. I mean, those long rebounds should be just like outlet passes with the speed in that Wake Forest backcourt.
Clemson now is 7 of 18. Hammonds launches the 19th shot, and he gets it to go down. Hammonds has been the real bright spot offensively for Clemson so far. Steal by Mays, misses the layup.
Oh, they're starting to come unraveled at the front of that press. But you've got to understand, Mays is awesome. James Mays, 6'9", junior, quick as a cat. And even if he doesn't steal it, he forces you to change the pass and change your angle. And over the course of 40 minutes, just totally intimidates insecure backcourt players.
A 60% free throw shooter. A couple of subs coming in. We've got Hale, number 4, checking back in, along with LD Williams. But Mays, he's Mr. Versatility, as we told you in the Star Watch segment in our open. He's 5th in the league in steals, 7th in field goal percentage, 9th in rebounding, does a little bit of everything, including shoot free throws. Skeen, good save by Skeen to get it to Smith. LD Williams off the mark.
Hey, Deacons, Fisher's in there. He's pretty good.
Look at Hamilton go. And a timeout taken by Wake Forest as Clemson has scored 6 unanswered points to take a 23-17 lead.
ESPN College Game Day is on campus. Saturday, first place in the ACC is up for grabs as the BC Eagles throw down with the Tar Heels. We'll predict which team will bust open your bracket.
You got guards that can play. You got a chance to get to the Sweet 16 no matter who you are.
And how a special tattoo motivates Washington State's Derek Lowe.
All I need to know is that I got my family close to me on my leg.
Plus, the in or out debate rages on. College Game Day driven by State Farm, 11 a.m. and 8 p.m. on ESPN.
Oliver Purnell and the Clemson Tigers up by 6. And he's got that good guard play we mentioned earlier. Hamilton, one of the co-captains on this year's team. Let's watch him go coast to coast, Buck.
The crossover. Whoop! When a guy makes a move like that in the middle of the floor, oh, this is embarrassing.
Smith tried to throw it in and hit the side of the backboard. And so Clemson is going to get the ball right back. That is the 6th turnover of the half for the Demon Deacons. Clemson trying to add to its 6-point lead. Powell with the ball into the game for the Tigers. Nice feed into Rivers. And Rivers into the scoring column for the first time tonight. Rivers, one of the leading scorers on this team, with 14 points per game.
Boy, heavy dribbles and adventure showing against his press.
And it is really wreaking havoc with 6 turnovers. Hale overshoots everything, rebound by Rivers.
The press has made him forget all about Kyle Mitchell, all about him.
Steal by Smith as Hamilton upset with himself. He lost it off of his chest. And Wake Forest slowing it down for the first time.
Hopefully to go inside and change his tempo.
There they go. Visser gets it to go down. I think they are the listening to you, Bucky.
I think that was four bounces on the rim. That should count as at least three.
That is Visser's fourth point, and he has now scored more points his senior season than he had scored in his entire career at Wake Forest prior to this year. That is exactly how much he has improved in the course of his career. Hale with the steal. Up the floor to Williams. Touch pass intended for Visser, but popped it way out of bounds. Skip Prosser furious about that. Now look at Kyle Visser, and you see the improvement he's made all 4 years here at Wake Forest.
Yeah, we mentioned before that we're talking about most improved player. We're not talking about the Atlantic Coast Conference. We're talking about the nation. This guy has paid his dues. He goes all the way back to a game in 2003 where he was in double figures against Carolina in the Smith Center. He's had his moments, usually early in the season, and then kind of faded out his junior and senior year, or sophomore and junior year. But this year, he has sustained it.
Rivers will try again. Still hasn't found the shooting rhythm tonight. Powell with a rebound. Kicks it to Mays. And Mays is fouled on the way to the basket. So James Mays will head to the free throw line, but before, timeout on the floor, 7:44 left to play in the opening half.
It is rude and insincere to tell a man he just dunked it. What kind of dunk was it? You got the windmill, the waffle cone, the Moroccan princess, the cranky valet, and oh! Now right there, that's the two-fisted, triple-pumping, intercontinental rim-wrecking double dunk. Call it what it is and give that man some respect.
NBA Street, on court, rated E for everyone.
Which team is going to be this year's big surprise?
What a pass!
Deep three! Oh,
it's in and he's fouled!
Starting Friday, it's time to find out.
Oh, my! Wow!
ESPNU brings you the games that could shake up the brackets.
He's got guts, I'll give him that.
Send a message to the elite teams.
Big time delivery!
And thrust them into the spotlight.
What a jumper! He buries him!
O'Reilly ESPNU Bracket Busters, beginning Friday at 9, only on ESPNU.
Bowflex Home Gyms. What do you want to be?
My name is Michael Palenko, and I'm 49 years old. I'm in the best shape of my life, and I'm living my dream. I'm playing in a rock band.
How can a 49-year-old man look so young and strong? He strength trains with Bowflex.
You got to see this free DVD. It'll change your life. In 10 weeks, I lost 26 pounds of fat. My waist dropped from a 36-inch down to about a 30. I love the way I look.
All it takes is one simple workout, 20 minutes a day, three times a week.
If you want to get a Bowflex body, you got to have a genuine Bowflex.
Own your very own Bowflex for no money down and payments as low as $14 a month.
Bowflex let me be who I wanted to be. I play in a rock band. I live my dream. I'm 49 years old, and this is a real Bowflex body.
Be strong. Be fit. Be Bowflex. Call or go online now for your free DVD that tells you all about Bowflex Home Gyms. Call now.
Tigers up by six. We're inside Lawrence Joel Coliseum in Winston-Salem, North Carolina for ACC basketball. I'm Sam Gore along with Bucky Waters. Clemson has built that six-point lead mostly because of the quick start from James Mays. He's got 8 points already.
James Mays only shoots 20% from three, but that's okay. With his strength and quickness and agility, he is like a missile going to the basket. He is everywhere and just death at the front of that press. He has so intimidated Wake Forest. They're hitting the side of the backboard, the support, everything, trying to get the ball in. What an athlete. Gardner, North Carolina. I wonder if any of the North Carolina schools in the ACC. Gardner's right down there between Durham and Raleigh and Chapel Hill. It's hard to believe that they didn't know about him.
Well, he went to the same high school as North Carolina's Donald Williams and Xavier's David West. So some good players have come out of that school. Mays increases the Tiger lead, and here's that press that has been frustrating the Deacons. Senior Drum trying to break it and does.
Skip Prosser's adjustment put Drum on the baseline as the inbound player, a senior, a little more experienced, not quite as quick and as athletic. If the ball comes back to him, he may struggle against that press.
Foul called as Drum drives to the basket. Fouls on Casey Rivers. Look at the early stats. Clemson shooting 46%, Wake Forest 43%. And the rebounding, finally, a stat that Clemson's leading in. Remember, they've been out-rebounded in their last several games. Visser gets loose, misses the dunk, but he's fouled, says Brian Kersey.
That's two that Visser has missed with his fingertips on the iron. That one was like an anvil. The other one just didn't get up over top. Don't you just love to see a big guy attack the basket like that?
He certainly is big. 6'11", about 260 pounds from Grand Rapids, Michigan. And connects on the first free throw. He's 64% free throw shooter.
In the ACC stats, he's third in field goal percentage, sixth in rebound, seventh in scoring. What a year.
You can see he and Tyler Hansborough have been to the line more often than any other players in the ACC this year. Wake Forest within six.
Hansborough, as good as he is, missed a free throw in that game last night.
Yeah.
Boy, he's a champ. My heart went out to him because he always delivers.
How about the freshman they sent in for Tech that hadn't played the whole game and had to shoot those two free throws? Oh, well, different game.
They missed the first one and hit the second. We're talking pressure here.
Drum has a shot blocked from behind. The Tigers, boy, they are just all over the Deacons defensively. They are just smothering the Deacons. Booker loses it on the way up, but he's fouled as well. Booker is a freshman starter for Clemson. Let's take a look at this last block.
Return to sender. Oh, it's Mays. I'm the prison. I asked Oliver Purnell today if he was concerned at all about tempo with it. He's got these great athletes, and he likes to turn them loose, and he didn't seem to think it was going to be a problem. Wake likes to go up and down as well, and boy, these two coaches know each other.
Yeah, he was happy that they would probably be running tonight as Skeen goes to the bench. Booker's on the free throw line. James Mays calls Booker a man child. He said, I couldn't believe he was 18 years old when he showed up on our campus. He's fearless.
50 blocks already for the freshman. He's only 6'7".
He had 10 in a game, or excuse me, 8 in a game earlier this year against Carolina. That's one short of Tree Rollins' freshman record. Wake Forest trying to get some offense going here. Only trailing by 6. Smith in the lane, knocks it down. Ish Smith. Skip Prosser calls him one of the quickest players in the country, and you can see why. So the Deacs within 4, and the fans here in Joel Coliseum trying to get behind them.
Smith was talking about having played against all of the great guards so far in the ACC except Vernon Hamilton, and he was looking forward to that tonight.
There was the man-child Booker knocking down the left-handed shot. 3 of Clemson's best players are left-handed, which is a little unusual in today's basketball world.
Boy, that's a great press when you get him from behind.
Hamilton has it blocked, but it is a goaltend. So the basket will go to Hamilton as the goaltend called against David Weaver. Weaver, that redshirt freshman from Black Mountain.
Ooh, I wasn't sure that was a goaltend.
Boy, Drum or Hale was wide open to catch that pass, and Booker swats it out of bounds.
Holy mackerel.
This is a defensive clinic put on by the Tigers here in this first half so far.
Everybody in the first 10 rows, you better get a tetanus shot because these balls are coming out there with the speed of having been hit with a 3-wood. They don't try, and unfortunately, they don't try to get a fast break off of these blocks. They just want to pulverize the ball.
Harvey Hale, the sophomore from Albuquerque, knocks down the 3-pointer. Actually signed with Wake Forest before he ever even visited the campus. Just kidding around. He said, I just wanted to get out of New Mexico.
Well, I'd say he did it.
He certainly did. And the Deacs within 5. Foul on Weaver, his second. College basketball on ESPNU continues Friday night. Doubleheader, 7 Eastern, catch an Ivy League matchup. Adam Gore, the Cornell Big Red, face the Princeton Tigers at 9. Albany Great Danes meet the Boise State Broncos as O'Reilly ESPNU Bracket Busters tips off. Three-pointer up and good by Hamilton.
Only 34% from three, but boy, it looks better than that. What a great release.
That's his second three-pointer of the game. He's the first Tiger in double digits tonight. That's his 10th point. Oliver Clemson pushes the lead up to 8.
Oliver Purnell anxious to get that 20th win this season.
A carry call. There was contact. But Gary Maxwell said the violation occurred with the dribble. And that is the 9th turnover for Wake Forest in this first half.
Hale's a little bit out of control. Curtis Blair, the official, trying to tell him to cool it, young man.
You mentioned, as we see Perry getting ready to come in, Curtis Blair, the official tonight. He actually was a heck of a college basketball player. He was this Colonial Athletic Association Player of the Year at the University of Richmond under Dick Tarrant. Oliver Purnell was the head coach at Old Dominion when Blair was playing. He's that official in the middle of your screen toward the bottom.
It looks like he can still play, Sam.
He certainly does. Offensive foul called against the Tigers. And there's Curtis Blair, played at Richmond in the late 80s, early 90s. Player of the year in the CAA. And he is very fit still. Look at him.
8 points. Clemson trying to put him away in the first half. Skip Prosser desperately trying to get control of his club and go in at halftime without a double-digit deficit. They have so many times this year dug huge deficits and been unable to overcome them despite some great comebacks.
Yeah.
And his kids are fearless. They never quit. But when you dig those big holes against teams in the ACC, you know, it's kind of like that saying, sometime you smell blood in the ACC, be careful. It could be yours.
4 times this year, Wake Forest has come back from double-digit deficits to win. Three-pointer up and good by Anthony Gurley. Oh, it's a 2 as the officials jump in and change the call. So a 2-pointer for Gurley. But one of my Wake Forest games here on ESPNU against Miami on January 3rd. The Deacons were down by 16 at halftime and came back to beat the Hurricanes by a point. Hammonds. Here come the Deacons. Gurley again. Off the mark. He's been in double figures his last 2 games, but can't pull Wake any closer.
Yeah, he put 12 on the Tar Heels in the Smith Center on Saturday.
Mays. Offensive foul on James Mays. So finally, something going right for Wake Forest.
ESPNU brings you college sports 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The passion, the anticipation, the excitement.
Wide open touchdown!
Every season.
This is for 3. Count it.
Every reason to watch.
Wisconsin wins!
Every sport all year round. Tomorrow night, Men's Hoops at 7:30. Ohio State looks to stay hot against Penn State. Then at 9, the Blue Devils face ACC powerhouse Boston College. ESPNU, always in season.
So, have you been on a lot of blind dates?
Well, this would make one.
Oh, yeah. Me too. What do you do?
I'm a vet.
I love animals.
Really? Where are you from?
Michigan, born and raised. Go Blue!
We're all big sports fans, but recently I had some trouble fitting in.
But Lance Armstrong probably wins 7 marathons, too.
He
was talking sports out of his...
out of my lack of information.
Please, the Spurs have no chance this year.
But then I started watching ESPN News. It's constantly updated, 24-hour sports news. So now I know sports. Better yet, I sound like I know sports.
2007 Bassmaster Classic, February 24th and 25th, only at ESPN2.
Mike Hall with a SportsCenter U update. Let's stay in that ACC, shall we? Maryland and NC State. This is Maryland's Eric Hayes. Finally, the ball stops, and he makes it go through the hoop. That stretches the lead to 7, but it's been a back-and-forth game. Now a 4-point game with 2.5 minutes left. Also, at halftime, we will have highlights of the other games you see here and much more. Let's go back out to Sam and Bucky.
Thank you very much, Mike. Let's take a look at the ACC standings. Last night's win for Virginia Tech pushed them into a tie with North Carolina, and Virginia in second place. Clemson trying to join those teams at the top of the ACC, hoping to get by Wake Forest tonight. And Wake Forest trying to avoid finishing in the cellar for the first time in back-to-back seasons. As that's where Wake Forest finished last year here in the ACC. They are not used to that here in Winston-Salem. Gurley for three, he's got it.
Young man's on a roll. Without Fisher in there, that's a good shot. I like to go inside out, but without Fisher, there's no inside.
Gurley with 7 points, and the Deacons are within three as we approach the final 3 minutes here in the opening half.
Yeah, this was the point we made a second ago, that it looked like that Clemson was going to take a huge, if not a double-digit lead to the locker room at halftime, and that's not good against a young team.
Tyler had to throw it up there with 2 on the shot clock, and a foul against Sykes on Clemson.
We've seen a lot of run and dunk. Here's a good job of making that extra pass, and the Deacons toe up at the head of the key, wide open. That helps your comeback.
Foul is on Sykes. Sykes is one of the youngsters in the Clemson program, a sophomore from Jacksonville, Florida. He's a nominee for Mr. Basketball down in that state a couple of years ago. He's a good shot blocker.
No way he could have gone to Florida with that hairdo. There would have been 2 of them.
Yeah. Very tolerant of that hair down there. I didn't know what you meant.
Well, if you can play like Noah, you can wear it any way you want, I guess.
Yes, you can. Skip Prosser watching Jamie Skeen now. Skeen, highest rated prospect coming in for his freshman class, and he brings the Deacons within 1.
Yeah, he's having a great freshman year. 2nd on the team in 3-pointers, rebounding, and blocks.
Yeah, Skeen was the state's player of the year after his junior season, but got an injury his senior year. Still made first team All-State, though. So how about these Deacons within 1? 2:40 left in the half. Tigers trying to stop the Deacon run. And Hammonds misses the layup, and an offensive foul called as well. Nothing going Clemson's way right now.
Boy, after building that nice 8-point lead, it looked like Clemson got a little greedy, attacking a little too hard. When you got that lead, you can afford to keep that opponent on defense a little bit, take a little out of his legs, but.
Hey, Smith, yeah! Ishmael Smith!
No question. There's a little demon in the Deacons right now. They are inspired.
Mays trying to show a little demon himself, but it's Williams with a rebound. Visser, no basket. He's fouled before the dunk. But let's go back to Ishmael Smith's nice move a moment ago to give Wake Forest the lead.
He could never put that down on an aircraft carrier. Oh, my goodness. Explosive. He is driving to score. He is not driving to pass. And sometimes that makes him look bad.
Hey, one of the best websites out there is ESPNU.com. The online gateway will connect you to all the college sports content from ESPN, combining news with an expanded collection of new exclusive material, scores, columns, video, audio, podcasts, live streaming games, much more. Go to ESPNU.com today. We are college sports. Well, Clemson seems to have just been bit by some bug here in Wake Forest. They, again, have lost 15 consecutive games and haven't scored more than 69 points in any of those losses. As Oliver Purnell trying to get rid of that streak tonight. And he's also trying to win a 20th game for Clemson. It would be the fourth different school Purnell had won 20 games at as well. What a milestone for that coach. Kyle Visser fouled before the dunk, so he'll have two free throws. And the first one rolls in. How about his shooting motion on this free throw, Buck? He looks a little funny.
Yeah, he's got that elbow over in front of his face. Most mechanics, free throw shooters, will tell you to keep it absolutely straight with your shoulder, and that makes it go absolutely straight. You don't have to worry about it going left or right. It's just a question of distance. But he's got a little crook in that thing, but he shoots it pretty well.
Wake Forest on an 11-0 run. Gurley trying to add to it. Mays with the rebound. Whoever's the scorer, instant offense for Clemson, but he's been quiet here in the first half.
Well, this game is NASCAR and sneakers. Both of these teams can't wait to get to the other end.
Hammonds kicks it out on the wing to Hamilton. In and out. Wow, what a follow, though, by Julius Powell, a 6'7 sophomore from Newton, North Carolina.
Both of these teams have impressive young big men.
Well, the future looks very good for both of these programs, as you're right. Smith again working inside. He can get open, can he?
He's got to take a little more time and find the spot. To trouble sometime when you have that much speed, the ball comes out quick and it hits hard. That's one of the things I like about Marvin Carolina. He's got a good mid-range game. That is something that Ishmael Smith has yet to develop.
Mays sends Visser to the deck. And a reminder, coming up at halftime, we'll go to SportsCenter U. We'll take a look at the game between Maryland and NC State. Also, number two, Oklahoma State in action. Ohio State in action. And the Big East highlights coming up as well. I'm sure the people in Oklahoma were, their ears were perked up when I said that. Ohio State, number two in the country, no doubt about it.
Kyle Visser at the line with two shots.
So Visser sent back to the free throw line by James Mays. Mays goes to the bench, as you just saw a shot of him.
Clemson had that 17-0 run. Then they lost a couple in a row at Maryland, North Carolina at home. Managed to win with Boston College, then lost three more. And came in here having swept a series, beat Florida State, having swept a series with the Seminoles. So they came in on an uptick.
And Wake Forest came in on a downtick after that terrible loss to North Carolina last weekend. Clemson, though, has had a week off, which is rare this time of year. Visser makes one of two, and Clemson's going to get it back as we approach the final 30 seconds of the first half. Clemson will have to shoot. They cannot hold it for one. Wake Forest up by two. And they're going to milk as much of this shot clock as they can. Hammonds with the ball. Now at 10. Tyler back to Hammonds. Shot clock hitting five. Hammonds around drum. Shoot. Scores. So score tied. Closing seconds of the half. Smith with one last shot. It's not going to count even if it went in, says Brian Kersey. So we are deadlocked at halftime. These two teams went to overtime twice last year. Could we be headed to another overtime? We're tied at 37 after 20 minutes. Let's head now to Mike Hall in the SportsCenter U studio for our halftime show.
Fellas, thanks. Knotted up at 37 here in our SportsCenter U studios along with Blue and Drew. I am Mike.
We like those bubble teams, especially in the ACC. With that in mind, here's the highlights taken on with Maryland and NC State. Ingen Atzer back in the lineup with a long three ball, and the Packer down two. Shortly after, Mike Jones has the answer.
Mike Jones, one of the seniors for Maryland, really can shoot the ball from the outside. He really needs to step it up and try to secure Maryland a W so they can try to get a bid.
And then Jones does it outside, does it inside. Terps up by seven. Gavin Grant finds Ben McCauley, who's wide open.
He's a nice player for NC State. Gives him a lot of baskets around the basket. He just needs that perimeter help to make sure he gets the basketball.
So the Terps lead 39-34 with 32 seconds left in the game. Maryland in or out as of right now, Drew?
Out right now.
Fair enough. Ohio State in or out, Blue?
Ohio State is definitely
Ohio
in.
Ohio State is in, definitely taking in on Penn State. Early on, it's 3-3. Geary Claxton, Blue. Sweet dish, and then gets it back.
Here's a guy here, 6'5", playing against a big guy. Taking to the basket strong, but you got to be careful. Greg Oden is still around that basket area.
And there's Danny Morrissey for three. Penn State with an early lead, but it's tied up at 10 when Daquan Cook gets the ball.
Daquan Cook, just one of those fabulous freshmen in that came in there. He's a tremendous scorer, really provides a lot of spark off the bench, really having a great season. And here he is shooting the three. He's just got a tremendous touch, but look at this. He misses this one, but who's there to clean it up?
Powerful slam.
Oden.
9.7 rebounds for G.O. early on. 40-19, not so much close, partly because Ohio State is holding the Nittany Lions to 27% shooting from the field. When we come back, we'll check in on the Big East. You got some bubble teams over there as well. Seton Hall, UConn, South Florida, Syracuse. Big games today.
Anticipation builds, the question remains, how to exceed expectations. Patience, because a game breaks down in time. Be wary of the minutes, but it's the seconds that change everything, for the moment will fall. So take the risk and play like there's no tomorrow. The NCAA Winter Championships on ESPN, ESPN2, and ESPNU.
Listen, I get the whole idea about you being the captain of Team USA and everything, but you're not really Captain America.
I know that.
Oh, you do? Well, then, how do you explain me finding this in your cubicle?
What's that? A shield?
You know it's a shield. It's an impenetrable shield, and you're taking the whole Captain America thing, I think, a little too far.
There it is. Sweet.
Neil, I found it.
Convention started an hour ago. Let's go.
Right on.
I'll see you later, man.
If you're watching TV without great sound, you're missing half the excitement. But when you connect your TV to the Bose 321 GS DVD home entertainment system, your movies, sports, and music come to life in an exciting home theater experience. Forget about complications of conventional five-speaker systems and all those wires running to the back of your room. With the 321 system, you only see two small speakers, while the Hideaway Acoustimass module delivers deep, dramatic lows for sound that John Budrys of Boston Globe magazine says rivals that of more expensive five-satellite units. And if you love music, ask about the 321 GSX system that lets you store 200 hours of your favorite CDs. So order today. It's risk-free. And if you order now, Bose will ship your system right to your front door free. Be sure to ask how you can make 12 easy payments with no interest charges from Bose. So why settle for half the experience when the 321 GS and GSX systems give you so much more?
Florida Beach Dogs not having a problem with the weather, but up in the Midwest and the Northeast, they certainly are. Look at all these games have been postponed one day, not happening today, moving to tomorrow because of the winter storm. But some are still playing in the Big East, South Florida and Syracuse. Darryl Watkins off the glass, Orange down one. Kentrell Gransbury. Maybe not a name everybody knows, but one they should know.
But certainly, here's a guy, as long as this game is a half-court game, he will be a big factor. Right now, sitting on 13 points and 9 rebounds, he's having a strong first half.
It's just in one half, looking nice. So's Josh Wright with the crossover. Orange down 3. Later on, Andy Routens from way downtown. We're talking Drew Barry range right there. Orange by 4. But it's a one-point game at the half. Syracuse shooting just 35% from the field, but they're looking for their 18th win. Seton Hall and Connecticut. This is Doug Wiggins on the defense and then on the offense with the slam. Later on, Jeff Adrian. We like the dunks here on the SportsCenter U. This would be nothing new here. Adrian gets it inside and will finish. And then AJ Price from the corner, Connecticut. NCAA or NIT right now, Drew?
Right now, they're NIT. They really need to step it up. They're right on the bubble. I mean, if they could finish the year up strong and maybe get 3 or 4 more wins, they've got a chance to sneak in.
14-12, Connecticut with the lead. 15-9 is their current record. Less than 10 minutes to go in the first half. Wakes Ishmael Smith with a nice move. It is 37-37 and a half. A few more highlights to get to right after this.
My name is Amy. I'm a single mom. When I saw this place for sale, it just looked homey. Refinished all the floors, all new windows, 5 stitches there, plenty of splinters. There are those projects that are 3 trip to the Home Depot, the 5 trip, or there could even be the 10 trip. They know their stuff. I went from feeling like I really couldn't do anything else to feeling like I can do whatever I want. If my girls do have heroes, I'd love to be one of them.
Water. You can't swim without it. You can't make a cup of coffee without it. You can't wash your car without it. Oh, yes, you can. Introducing the Zero H2O Car Care System, the new way to clean and shine your car without water. That's right, no water, and that means no more messy hoses and buckets ever again. Zero H2O actually cleans your car better than water ever could. When you wash your car the old-fashioned way, you can use up to 100 gallons of water, and the sponge can actually grind the dirt into your car and scratch the finish, but not with Zero H2O. Its advanced wetting agents penetrate, emulsify, and lift the dirt away while forming a protective scratch-free barrier between the dirt and your car. Just spray on Zero H2O, wipe off the dirt, and bring on the shine. And there's no more wasted water. Zero H2O is perfect for every surface on your car and every mess in every season. It works wonders on road salt and mud on painted metal. Dirt's no match for Zero H2O on vinyl and plastic. Out of my way, brake dust on chrome, and bird droppings on glass and rubber don't have a chance.
It just does a great job. It's the best product I've ever used for cleaning my car. I don't expect to ever find another one as good as it.
You just put it on, take it off, takes 20 minutes, cuts two and a half hours worth of work.
Zero H2O comes with this power sprayer that delivers the perfect amount of formula for maximum coverage. It even works on interiors from dashboards to leather seats. Call now to try this car cleaning miracle for yourself. You'll also get the power sprayer for maximum coverage, plus 2 streak-free gloss cloths, all for just $19.95. But wait. Call now and we'll supersize you to the giant 32-ounce size. Best of all, we'll give you a full 12 months to try Zero H2O. Use it indoors during the winter, outside in the summer, or anytime in between. If you're not 100% satisfied, send back the empty bottle for a full refund of the price. But keep the power sprayer and the 2 gloss cloths as our gifts to you. So you would never try drinking coffee without water, but you'll definitely want to wash your car without it. Call now.
Here's a bully for Ole Mizzou, taking on Baylor, Henry Duguid. You know, looking is so overrated. Kevin Rogers will finish. Baylor up 3. Then how about this play? That's Mizzou's Keon Lawrence with the block. So the play's still going on. Missouri breaks down the court, and that's the ball for the Tigers. So then we got Matt Lawrence, right? And he's got a shot here. He's a good sharpshooter, but he misses. So then Keon Lawrence puts it back, and it's good. Play's over. Mizzou's up 7 with the inbounds pants for Baylor. And it's Curtis Gerald's going coast to coast. Nobody gonna stop him. 35-32, Tigers over Bears. Tigers always beat Bears. It's a nature of law, according to Stephen Colbert. How about Charleston Southern against Winthrop? Donald Covington drains a 3. Charleston down 8 when Shelton Carter gets a big 3, cutting the lead down to 5. But Michael Jenkins can take over. What did you learn from when we had Winthrop head coach Greg Marshall on earlier today?
I think the biggest thing I learned was the fact that he has his team playing with the policy that playing hard is not an option. When you watch these guys play, they do indeed play hard. Michael Jenkins, the leading scorer, providing a lot of offensive plays for that basketball team.
40-19, Eagles have the lead. George Mason, Delaware. Herb Courtney drives and finishes, or an early dunk for him. It's 8 up when there's a steal. Fowler and Campbell, John Vaughn, hello. George Mason up 10-8. It's 12-11 when Will Thomas cuts down the lane and gets the layup and gets the foul. Did not get the free throw. George Mason up 30-20. So it's 37 up in your game, which brings our attention back to the ACC. As of right now, how many teams are in the tournament in that conference?
If the NCAA tournament was tomorrow, I would say that there's 6 teams. I think Georgia Tech and Maryland are on the way out. They're really struggling. They're 5-6 in the conference. I think if you don't look at it as tomorrow and you look at it as 3 or 4 weeks from now, I think Georgia Tech could get anywhere from 6 to 8. I'm not saying Duke's a lock. I mean, Duke is struggling right now. They've lost 4 in a row. Could potentially lose tonight at Boston College. That's 5 in a row. They could really struggle. And Clemson, a team that's really struggling in the last few ball games, 2-5. If they don't win out and finish strong, they could be out.
I think right now 6 would be strong, possibly 7 if Maryland, basically what they have to do is really win their remaining basketball games. They have 3 games at home, and they probably have to go on the road and win at least 1 basketball game for them to really feel good about their NCAA chances.
So Clemson might be on the bubble, Duke too. Duke has a big game against Boston College tonight. What do you want to see from the Blue Devils?
Well, I'd like to see a little bit of heart and a little bit of passion. I mean, they've lost 4 games in a row. Coach K's never lost 5 games in a row in his time at Duke. I think that they really have to come out and set the tone early. They're known for their defense, and that's where they're going to make their bread and butter tonight. They've got to get steals. They've got to get rebounds and run. I'm really hoping that Paulus has a good game and McRoberts.
I really think for Duke that the biggest thing right now, they have to find a way to pull themselves off the court. And it really starts with developing somebody off that bench so your starters, your top 6 guys, don't have to play all the minutes.
And again, we will have highlights of that one later on tonight as we wrap up a SportsCenter U around 11 o'clock. But you still got a second half to get to. It is 37-all. Our guys have the call right after this.
The Indianapolis Colts have won their first Super Bowl.
He scores! Touchdown!
Relive all the thrills with Sports Illustrated and this must-have NFL Films DVD, The Indianapolis Colts Super Bowl 41 Champions. Plus, this hardcover commemorative book captures the Colts' incredible season through SI's famous writing and photography. Go to SIIndieOffer.com or call now to get both free with your paid subscription to SI. 56 issues for only $1.75 an issue. Save over 55% off the cover price. Use your credit card and get this collectible football honoring the champion Colts. Designed exclusively for Sports Illustrated, it features scores from the entire season and includes a display stamp and certificate of authenticity. Celebrate the Colts' unforgettable victory with the official Super Bowl DVD, the SI commemorative book, and the exclusive football. This limited championship package is only available from Sports Illustrated. Go to SIIndieOffer.com or call right now.
Touchdown!
Now, who can tell me how much distance we need to keep between ourselves and the car in front of us? Mr. Light.
Just enough to get a good draft, I guess. 2 or 3 inches?
Correct. And, no way, you mean 2 or 3 seconds?
Seconds for what?
Seconds behind.
I'm not getting 2 or 3 seconds behind anybody.
You mean inches?
The NASCAR Busch Series on ESPN2. Season begins Saturday at Daytona.
On March 9th, experience a groundbreaking vision of mankind's first fight for freedom.
Your husband, our king, has taken 300 of our finest to slaughter.
From the creator of Sin City.
This is Sparta!
We're in for one wild night.
Rated R. Only in theaters and IMAX March 9th.
Sunday, the rules will be broken. Iconic predators will fight for their lives. Threatened by outsiders, their environment, and archenemies. Because even the invincible are vulnerable. On Planet Carnivore. Sunday, starting at 8 on Channel 276, the National Geographic Channel. Dare to explore.
Back in Joel Coliseum, we are deadlocked at 37 all at halftime. And wow, what a great first half, Bucky. There was so little to differentiate these two teams.
They were going at high speed and they were fearless. The errors were colossal. The good plays were just as great.
But we didn't have any problems finding highlights from this opening half as there were some electrifying plays.
James Mays, the junior from Clemson, number 40, had 9 points, 2 assists, and a steal. And Ishmael Smith, as advertised, the jet with the ball, he had 6 points, 3 assists, 2 turnovers. And the big fella, Kyle Bitcher, had 8 points, only 2 for 3 from the floor, but he was 4 for 6 from the foul line.
And you can see from the stats just how close it was. Both teams shooting 45%, rebounding about even, points off turnovers. Pretty close. Wake Forest turned the ball over 9 times. Clemson turned it over 8 times. Our Star Watch update, Mays with 9 points, Visser with 8.
I'll tell you the interesting stat to me. Wake Forest was 12 for 14 from the foul line, and they have struggled there so this year, shooting only 62%, but they shot 14 free throws. Clemson, on the other hand, shot only 6 free throws and made 3. So that's how the Deacons got back in it. 20 more minutes.
Smith will set it up for Wake Forest on the first possession of the second half.
All right, the backcourt of Hamilton and Hammonds each had 10 points.
Oh! Oh, swatted by Perry. Perry says,
turn to sender.
Hamilton for 3. And it's run down by Booker. Stolen away by Hale. Hale on the layup, blocked from behind. Boy, how about some athleticism on the opening couple of possessions here?
Great no call. Great no call.
That is Hammonds coming over from behind.
You better get there quick. You better get there high and then duck.
Hammonds only 6'3", Cairo, Georgia, one of those co-captains. You see Clemson's got 4 blocks against Wake tonight. No score yet here in the first minute of the second half.
Good. Let the big guy handle it.
Visser banks it in, and he's fouled by Perry.
Good thing for Wake Forest, Visser has only 1 personal foul, so Skip Prosser doesn't have to be worried about him in foul trouble. And that's the other thing. When you get that ball down inside the Visser, he's so active, he draws fouls. He puts fouls on the key premium frontline players of the opponent, and they either have to play a little softer or they have to sit down. And that's a fact a lot of teams don't recognize. They're always shooting fadeaways.
Visser puts Wake Forest up by 3, first 3 points of the half for either team. And Visser on the defensive end this time, making a nice play, knocks it out of bounds. Clemson will keep it. Visser, they haven't had to worry about him being in foul trouble too much over the course of his career. He did foul out against North Carolina Saturday, but it was only the 3rd time he had fouled out in his career. And the 1st time since his freshman year he had fouled out.
A guy named Hansborough probably had something to do about that. You talk about a bull. I love him. His concentration, focus, he attacks you.
Booker gets the layup for Clemson's first bucket of the second half. Booker had 8 points against Florida State and has 4 tonight against Wake Forest.
Booker was no secret. Oh, here's the good move inside again.
Smith on the drive, misses the layup. Visser will try to clean it up, can't make it. And the battle for the rebound won by the Tigers.
Visser tried to use that left hand, which he does very well in close. I'm not saying he's amphibious. I'm saying he's amphibious.
I'm glad you cleared that up.
One of my fellow alums at North Carolina State made that statement famous.
Charles Shackelford.
I wasn't going to say his name. He's bigger than me.
Skeen. Jamie Skeen knocking down another 3-pointer. They say he's got unlimited potential. He had never lifted a weight before he came to Wake Forest. He is very raw and very good. Skeen puts the Deacons up by 4.
Skipper's Kitty Core very confident now coming out after the half.
Skeen and Visser in double figures for Wake Forest. Booker pushed from behind. Couple of guys were on him, and I think they're going to get LD Williams for it. No, excuse me, Harvey Hale gets called for the foul. So 17:41 left to play. Clemson and Wake Forest, they went to overtime twice last year, each team winning on its home floor. Hammond, short shot, knocks it down. Cliff Hammonds pulls Clemson within two.
There's that mid-range game that the veteran backcourt from Clemson had. That's a tough shot there. A little eight-footer, can't use the board. Just got to be great touch.
Hammonds was a great high school football player. In fact, Wake Forest recruited him to play football here. He was going to go to Stanford to play football or Clemson to play basketball, and we all know what he picked. Visser stolen away from behind by Rivers. Mays comes out of there with it. Again for three, short. Booker with a rebound, cleans it up and in.
Trevor Booker, oh my, what an offensive rebound.
On the other end, Hale misses the layup. Clemson with a chance to take the lead for the first time here in the second half. Mays, layup good.
And immediately Mays turns to front that press.
And an offensive foul called on Hale. Fans don't like it. Visser struggling a little bit inside.
But he's relentless. You keep doing that, you're going to go to the foul line. Something good's going to happen. But that time, the Tigers tripped him. He'll be back.
Clemson up by two. The offensive foul at midcourt committed by Hale. Well, these two teams, as we mentioned, have played close games the past couple of years. Their coaches have been going at each other for many years, back in their Atlantic 10 days when Purnell was head coach at Dayton and Skip Prosser was head coach at Xavier. They're very good friends, these two coaches. And their teams play much like their coaches' personalities, hard-nosed. Layup is good by Hamilton. 4-point lead by the Tigers. Here's the press again, broken easily by the Deacons. LD Williams misses another layup.
Fisher that time. Good thing he didn't bring it down. He put it right back up as the big man should, keeping the ball high. But the athleticism of the guys in orange is just sometimes just amazing.
The foul's on Hammonds. Visser's going to go to the free throw line. Half of his points in that first half were from the charity stripe.
He didn't get that many touches. Not enough, in my opinion.
Both teams have struggled from the free throw line all season. They're 11th and 12th in the ACC. There's their stats. It's been even worse in conference play.
Oh, my. That's like a turnover. When you can't hit your free throws, it's a turnover.
Visser makes good on that one. Visser 5 of 8 from the line to make that 6 of 9 tonight. 12 points. And Wake Forest within 3. We were tied at 37 at halftime as we played 4.5 minutes approximately here in the second half. Hammonds is fouled on the way to the basket by Williams. 47-44. This one very close. Skip Prosser and Oliver Purnell, longtime rivals. We'll get more into that when we come back.
The 2006 Bobby Dodd Coach of the Year winner takes place February.
College hockey, Dartmouth versus Yale, Sunday at 4 p.m. on ESPNU.
Hi, I'm Magic Johnson. Welcome to the fundamentals of basketball.
To be the best, you have to learn from the best. That's why basketball legend Magic Johnson has assembled the greatest team of all-star players and coaches to help players everywhere improve their skills and knowledge of the sport. The Magic Fundamentals comprehensive video program is over 2 hours of instruction from basketball greats Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Diana Taurasi, Carmelo Anthony, Kenny Smith, Amari Stoudemire, and Rip Hamilton. Now you can own Magic Fundamentals comprehensive program on 2 DVDs by calling the number on your screen or by visiting our website at magicjohnsondvd.com. Whether you're just a beginner or you're playing at the highest levels of high school ball, Magic's program will help you dramatically improve your game.
We all are looking to get better, and this tape will make you better if you practice the drills over and over again. You don't have to go to camp. I'm bringing camp right to you.
The Magic Fundamentals comprehensive video is filled with everything you need to know to increase your points, assists, rebounds, and understanding of the game of basketball. So call now and take the first step to becoming a great basketball player with Magic Fundamentals on two DVDs. Order now and get Magic's conditioning DVD free to help you get stronger, quicker, faster, and jump higher to maximize your basketball skills. That's over 2 hours of basketball instruction on two DVDs, plus the free conditioning DVD for two payments of only $19.99. And when you call, ask how you can own other DVDs from the Magic Fundamentals library. For young kids, Magic Johnson's Fundamentals of Basketball for Kids teaches the key basics that every beginner needs. And Magic's Advanced DVD is ideal for more skilled players and coaches, including how to run the power offense from one of the most successful high school coaches in America. Order Magic Fundamentals comprehensive program for two payments of $19.99 plus $5.95 shipping and handling and get the conditioning DVD free. Remember to ask how you can own Magic's for Kids or Advanced DVDs. Call now or order online. Rush delivery available.
Clemson up by three. Oliver Purnell and Skip Prosser. This is the 19th time they have faced each other as head coaches at the Division I level. The rivalry goes back to when they were both in the Atlantic 10. Prosser leads the overall series 11-7. Since they've been in the ACC, Prosser's been pretty dominant, 4-1 against Purnell. Remember, Prosser was head coach at Xavier, Purnell head coach at Dayton for a long time, and they're very good friends, however. In fact, in today's world of college basketball, you don't see coaches with each other very much before games, and when the teams were just out warming up before any of the fans were really here, those two were sitting on the bench together for about 15 minutes about 6 o'clock tonight.
That is unusual.
Sykes, offensive foul.
Yeah, I think about coaches. I think back to Rick Barnes when he coached Clemson. I happened to work a game in the ACC tournament where it was the exact opposite. Oliver Purnell is just, you know, really under control. When there was a questionable call of a hard foul on a Carolina player, Dean Smith went after the player. Rick Barnes went after Dean Smith. They ended up nose to nose at midcourt. And Commissioner Gene Corrigan had to call him to his home the next day to unravel it.
They sure did, but these two guys like each other. We've got a break in the action. Crimson up by three.
Water. You can't swim without it. You can't make a cup of coffee without it. You can't wash your car without it. Oh, yes, you can. Introducing the Zero H2O Car Care System, the new way to clean and shine your car without water. That's right, no water, and that means no more messy hoses and buckets ever again. Zero H2O actually cleans your car better than water ever could. When you wash your car the old-fashioned way, you can use up to 100 gallons of water, and the sponge can actually grind the dirt into your car and scratch the finish. But not with Zero H2O. Its advanced wetting agents penetrate, emulsify, and lift the dirt away while forming a protective scratch-free barrier between the dirt and your car. Just spray on Zero H2O, wipe off the dirt, and bring on the shine. And there's no more wasted water. Zero H2O is perfect for every surface on your car and every mess in every season. It works wonders on road salt and mud on painted metal. Dirt's no match for Zero H2O on vinyl and plastic. Out of my way, brake dust on chrome, and bird droppings on glass and rubber don't have a chance.
Just does a great job. It's the best product I've ever used for cleaning my car. I don't expect to ever find another one as good as it.
You just put it on, take it off, takes 20 minutes, cuts two and a half hours worth of work.
Zero H2O comes with this power sprayer that delivers the perfect amount of formula for maximum coverage. It even works on interiors from dashboards to leather seats. Call now to try this car cleaning miracle for yourself. You'll also get the power sprayer for maximum coverage, plus two streak-free gloss cloths, all for just $19.95. But wait. Call now and we'll supersize you to the giant 32-ounce size. Best of all, we'll give you a full 12 months to try Zero H2O. Use it indoors during the winter, outside in the summer, or anytime in between. If you're not 100% satisfied, send back the empty bottle for a full refund of the price. But keep the power sprayer and the two gloss cloths as our gifts to you. So you would never try drinking coffee without water, but you'll definitely want to wash your car without it. Call now.
In Winston-Salem, the home team trailing by three in the second half, 15:25 left. A reminder, college basketball on ESPNU continues Friday as a doubleheader, 7 Eastern. It's the Ivy League matchup between Cornell and Princeton. And then at 9, we kick off the O'Reilly ESPNU Bracket Busters, the Albany Great Danes beating the Boise State Broncos. Here's some of the teams that are in the bracket busters this year that are of note. Remember George Mason last year getting to the Final Four. They will be playing this year. And four other Elite Eight teams from last year in action as well. That's the O'Reilly ESPNU Bracket Busters, and it kicks off Friday night.
ESPN just did a great thing with that Bracket Buster, giving the visibility to those so-called mid-majors, which is now can start an argument. The mid-major is, I don't know how many there are, but there's a lot of majors. They just come from small schools.
LD Williams airballs the three. Clemson gets it back, trying to build on the three-point lead. Clemson has been to the NIT the last 2 years. They have missed the NCAA tournament since the end of the 97-98 season. Mays, Booker gets loose for the layup underneath. And Clemson trying to get to that NCAA tournament for the first time since that 1990 season.
Inside. Oliver Brunell now has backed up the full court press, but it's still 1-3-1, but at the half court level. And I think that's out of respect to Ishmael Smith, who's been just blowing through the full court version.
Visser now with 14 points. Hamilton tries to add a three-pointer. Misses badly, rebounded by LD Williams. 14 minutes left to play. Williams a little out of control. Missed the shot, though. Well, he actually got himself pretty open.
Well stated. Looked like a young deer on ice, man.
There's Mays underneath. Tried to give him the basket earlier. James Mays putting it in to push Clemson up by five.
He needs more touches in the lane, too. He'll put your people in foul trouble.
Michael Drum, the senior from nearby Rural Hall, North Carolina, spent his first 2 years at Presbyterian College. Gets Wake right back in it, a two-point Clemson lead.
Looks like Wake's trying to match up right now, trying to neutralize and slow the Tigers down.
9 three-pointers between the two schools tonight. Hamilton, a nice two-pointer off the glass.
Wake's got to remember he's left-handed, Sam. He just keeps making that same move right down there with that little bank shot.
Ish Smith, that's a nice little move as well.
You know what I think this is? I think it's a game of horse between these two point guards. Can you play top this? Wake now showing a 2-3, but they're matching from it.
It just can't get any closer. I mean, these guys have battled hard tonight, trading basket for basket. Again, Wake Forest hasn't missed the postseason the last 16 years. They've got to finish strong for any hope at the postseason. Mays for three. 9 on the shot clock. Ish Smith with a rebound for the Deacons. Smith takes it himself, and an offensive foul. Fans don't like it. Neither does Smith.
Well, he's just totally out of control. The young man's going to be a very good player when he learns the mid-range game. He has no concept. This is not a 100-yard dash with the basketball. And he's got teammates who are there, who are open. He's oblivious. Watch this. There's only one thought on his mind. Get to the rim.
And
at this level, Sam, sorry, there's going to be a good athlete, a big athlete, probably there to meet you.
I was going to say, unfortunately, he's getting to the bench right now. Hamilton again. He's got that short little opening he's found, and he's taking advantage of it. And a turnover by Wake Forest follows.
Well, there's a good comparison there. Ishmael Smith, the freshman, Hamilton, the senior, and Hamilton has the mid-range game. He knows when to hit the afterburners, show you the speed. He knows when to be under control. It'll all come for Smith. He's still learning.
I am very much looking forward to watching him over the next 4 years here at Wake Forest.
He's got a heck of a coach, too, in Skip Plotzer.
Well, Smith actually leads Wake in rebounding tonight. Stolen away. Hamilton that time lost the ball in the lane. Joe Dukes with it now for the Demon Deacons. His name's Shemaine, but he goes by Joe, and nobody's ever been able to tell me why. He won't give it away.
Maybe he's in the witness protection.
Dukes. This is Gurley, and Gurley's fouled on the way to the basket. Clemson up by four, and James Mays has been the man for the Tigers with 13 points.
Little House on the Prairie.
Yes! Yes!
One more, go, another, go, quick, 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 quick. Okay, three words, three syllables. First word, hook. Hook,
yes!
Hook, hook, hook. Okay. Go, what else? Hook, horns.
Yes!
Hook, horns.
Yes!
Hook.
You so got it.
Come on.
Come on,
man.
No, I don't.
Oh, no. Not
deer. An insane deer.
Deer? That's not.
Wow. There you go.
Paper.
What?
Taco meat.
Which team is going to be this year's big surprise?
What a pass!
Deep three! Oh.
It's in and he's fouled!
Starting Friday, it's time to find out.
Oh, my! Wow!
ESPNU brings you the games that could shake up the brackets.
He's got guts, I'll give him that.
Send a message to the elite teams.
Big time delivery!
And thrust them into the spotlight.
Oh, jumper, he buries him!
O'Reilly ESPNU Bracket Busters, beginning Friday at 9, only on ESPNU.
Would you turn down playtime to watch overtime? Would you wear your colors in enemy territory? Would you use a fight song for a lullaby? Would you put your season tickets in a prenup? Would you cheer when everyone in the bar groans? Would you move your significant other's precious oil paintings to clear space for a 6-foot image of your favorite player? Are you fan enough, Fathead?
It's not just about reaching your goals. It's about reaching your dreams, too. Now with HSBC Direct Online Savings, you'll earn 6% APY on new money until April 30th, 11 times the national savings average. Go to hsbcdirect.com for details and reach your goals and your dreams faster.
Mike Hall back in the studios following a developing situation. Florida and Alabama. This is Corey Brewer helping things out for the Gators, but it has not been Florida the whole time. In fact, Richard Hendricks here helps make it 28-13. This game started off with an 11-0 Alabama run. And how about this, Sam? 13 points. Number one team Florida is down.
Man, Mike, that looks like a football score. A lot of upsets in college basketball every week. Last night, North Carolina going down. Athletic teams in the SEC, athletic teams in the ACC here in Winston.
It's like a block party. You go for that basket, you better have a tetanus shot or a helmet, because somebody's going to come flying at you. And they may get the ball, and they may get something with ears. They don't care. They're going to get something. KC Rivers has been strangely quiet tonight, the great sixth man for Clemson this year.
Yeah.
Only 2 points, and they desperately needed his boost off the bench.
Gurley at the free throw line for Wake Forest. Rivers is in there for Clemson right now. He had 17 against Florida State last week. But broken out, he thought of a scoring slump. He came off the bench and scored in double figures in the first 18 games of the season. But Rivers in the lineup for Clemson right now has been quiet, as Bucky said. He's got the ball as we speak. Hammonds takes it. Clemson being pretty patient on this possession. Nursing the 4-point lead. And they can be patient when they get shots like that. Unfortunately, Mays didn't get it to go down. And a steal from Hammonds. Hamilton, actually one of the best guys in the ACC in the history of grabbing steals.
Yeah, I think he's 10th all time.
He's 10th all time. He's Clemson's career leader. Sykes misses the short shot. And all of a sudden, it's a disadvantage to be near the rim.
Clemson's getting awfully close and awfully good looks. They just can't get it down.
Gurley wide open for three. No good. And we've got some cold shooting going on both ends of the floor right now.
And when that happens, you go inside. You put it on the floor, you take it to the basket, you go to your big guy, you don't keep taking that quick three.
Rivers trying to create something. Nice backdoor cut. And Hamilton misses the layup, but he's going to get free throws. good pass from Rivers to Hamilton.
I know the Wake Forest coaching staff, and it's a good win. We'll use this tape, this DVD, to show what a solid backcourt Clemson has and how careful and how cautious, even with their great quickness, they take care of the basketball. That again, I use the term mid-range game. It isn't all quick threes and blowouts. There's a whole lot of good things that happen from the top of the key to the box.
Hamilton at the free throw line for Clemson. He scored in double figures his last 9 games, and he's the leading scorer right now for Clemson tonight. That's his 18th point. Now we're in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Wake Forest University hosting Clemson in this ACC matchup. LD Williams gets the layup.
You just knew he was not going to pass. It was 2-on-1, and he had his ears back, and he was going for the rim.
Williams has gone for the rim in the form of dunks lots of times this year for Wake Forest. In fact, he was the number one play of the day on SportsCenter earlier this year. An unbelievable dunk he had here at Georgia Tech. Good defense by Wake Forest is the timeout. Clemson's implored the press for most of the game, Bucky. Here's how they try to break it.
This time they went back and right to the middle. That's where the hole is. And of course, at the other end, the attack was complete. Sometimes with 2-on-1, again, you know, if you got the ball, you got to slow down just a little bit and find out what the defense is going to do. You got the advantage. Capitalize.
Coming up after our game, stick around at 9 o'clock. It's a Big East showdown. The Cincinnati Bearcats face Curtis Sumter and the Villanova Wildcats. Again, that's college basketball at ESPNU tonight at 9 Eastern. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com.
I can see a tremendous improvement, Sam, in this young Wake Forest team. NC State played a very similar defensive scheme against them early January, and it was awful. It was 50-32 at the half with the Wolfpack and Atra, their great point guard, wasn't even playing. It was all done with turnovers and layups.
There's Rivers missing again. Smith, again, the point guard leading Wake Forest in rebounds tonight. Gets it to Williams, and Williams again out of control, this time walks with it. And you know, all I can say, Bucky, is the other ACC teams, get your licks in this year on Wake Forest, because they've got some talent here, and they are going to be a force to be reckoned with over the next 3 seasons.
You know, a lot of coaches, what's hard right now is to remain patient. Sometimes with some of these horrendous errors of commission, and that's a good thing. I mean, they're trying things, they're fearless. Well, coaches will get upset and say, sit down, and then they put out the fire. So far, Prosser has kept the fire.
Smith broke that up again, finding Williams, and Williams can't find the bottom of the basket. Finally does. It was worth the wait.
Passion, LD Williams. The 6'4 freshman. Now this time there's a good pass. He's under control. Not once, not twice. Oh yeah. Come on back. Come on back. Yeah.
LD Williams, the freshman out of Yadkinville, North Carolina.
That's about a par 5 from here, Sam. I've always admired Wake. Has done a really good job of getting area kids that, you know, they're not McDonald All-Americans. They're just good players, and they come here, they're glad to be here, they get well coached, and Wake Forest has had a good tradition of that.
10th highest rated recruiting class nationally for Wake Forest coming in this year. If McDonald's All-Americans were judged on dunking ability, I think LD Williams would have been one. Last year, in his senior year in high school, he won the senior showcase dunk contest. He jumped over 2 racks of balls for a two-handed dunk. That was his first one. And then he won the contest by adding a local radio DJ, jumped over him, and slammed it. How about that?
I had my get well card all made out to the DJ, but fortunately he didn't need it. You gotta be a little nuts to stand under that guy flying.
Wake is within one.
got the crowd in it too. Joel Coliseum could give you some support. This place can rock.
No one in a Clemson uniform has ever won in this building. Somewhere you wonder if that's in the back of their minds. Mays carries it, turning it over to the Deacons.
James Mays with 7 double-doubles this year. 8 times he doubles in rebounds, and here he's showing us a complete array of skills.
And just when we think Clemson may be pulling away, this stat pops into your mind as Wake finds a way to get back in it. Clemson trying to break that 15-game losing streak tonight. And a turnover by Smith. His man wasn't there. And Clemson's going to get it back. And Clemson is also going to get some time to talk. Timeout on the floor. A lot of emotion tonight between these two ACC rivals.
Honey, I think I found the problem.
Want an easy way to keep your engine clean? Use Conoco Phillips 66 and 76 Quality Pro Clean gasolines. They meet the tough standards to help keep your engine running its best. Conoco Phillips 66 and 76 Quality Pro Clean gasolines.
The Indianapolis Colts have won their first Super Bowl.
He scores! Touchdown!
Relive all the thrills with Sports Illustrated and this must-have NFL Films DVD, The Indianapolis Colts Super Bowl 41 Champions. Plus, this hardcover commemorative book captures the Colts' incredible season through SI's famous writing and photography. Go to SIIndieOffer.com or call now to get both free with your paid subscription to SI. 56 issues for only $1.75 an issue. Save over 55% off the cover price. Use your credit card and get this collectible football honoring the champion Colts. Designed exclusively for Sports Illustrated, it features scores from the entire season and includes a display stamp and certificate of authenticity. Celebrate the Colts' unforgettable victory with the official Super Bowl DVD, the SI commemorative book, and the exclusive football. This limited championship package is only available from Sports Illustrated. Go to SIIndieOffer.com or call right now.
Hey, it's Valentine's Day, and there's a lot of love in the air for Wake Forest from these fans tonight. And what a year for Wake Forest athletics. It's been not just the basketball program, the football team going to the Orange Bowl. You've got field hockey, men's soccer, both going to the national semifinals. Women's soccer, women's cross country, both made the NCAA tournament. Spring sports look good for Wake Forest, too. Baseball, men's, women's, tennis, golf, all nationally ranked. Focusing more on basketball, shooting percentages. That's been a struggle for both teams lately. And turnovers. Wake has turned it over 2 more times at Clemson tonight. Free throws. Wake Forest has shot 20 free throws, while Clemson's only shot 8. So here we go, 7:54 left. It's a 1-point game. It'll be Clemson's ball.
Wake Forest now extending the defense a little bit. I don't know if that Ishmael Smith exuberance or what, but he wants to get a little closer to his idol for the evening, senior Vernon Hamilton.
Smith grew up idolizing Isaiah Thomas. That was his favorite NBA player. Booker! The man-child, says James Mays.
Boy, how he got that one past Kyle Visser, I don't know. Visser's snoozing a little bit down there.
Booker, South Carolina's Gatorade Player of the Year last year, coming to Clemson and giving the Tigers a 3-point lead.
Well, Clemson can win tonight. It'll give them 3 ACC road wins. That's impressive.
Be the first time they've had that since the 96-97 season. They've beaten Florida State and NC State on the road this year. Shot clock down to 5. Drum fires it up, hits the rim, but Booker gets the rebound.
Boy, I can understand the tag on Booker of man-child. Wow. Wait till he develops. He's just a kid.
He was 18 when he entered. He's 19 now. He was only 5'10 his freshman year in high school. He grew.
How much?
5'10". He grew 5 inches his ninth grade year.
Boy, that's good coaching.
Smith misses the layup. Rivers was out of bounds, so Wake's going to keep it. Well, Mays, his good friend James Mays, a junior, talking about Booker, and he has no problem throwing in the pass.
Boy, I tell you, watch that ball. He threw it by Visser. He could have thrown that ball to a car wash and not got it wet. That was a blur. No wonder Visser didn't get it.
Booker.
Good hands on Booker, too.
He immediately impressed the upperclassmen when he got to Clemson in the summer scrimmages. And he started his first game as a Clemson Tiger. Shot is missed by Skeen. As we head toward the final 6 minutes, Clemson trying to create some space between itself and Wake Forest, but that's not been easy. Hamilton's going to be up. Oh, he banks it in. Wow, I thought that was off. It was right in front of us. And if it weren't for the backboard, he would have missed that badly.
He took a divot out of the glass. I'll tell you that. That was a wedge shot. Oh, my.
Hamilton, a backbreaker. Pushes the Clemson lead up to six. He only shoots 34% from three.
He didn't smile, but he did a little double clutch and a little dance like, yeah, I'll take it. I'll take it.
An answered prayer. So Wake trying to push it. Needing a bucket here as they've fallen down by six.
Yeah, they need to get a little more movement and penetration. They're moving the ball around the outside of this Clemson defense, and it's too quick. You've got to penetrate.
Haven't heard from Visser in a while.
There he is. Good.
And Visser is fouled. Had two guys on him. Hammonds came over the top and got the foul. And that is the fourth foul on Hammonds.
And that's because the ball is going into the big guy. If it goes in more, you get more of your opponent's inside players in foul trouble.
Not a smart play from Hammonds, and being smart is something he's grown used to. Hammonds is a great story. He was his high school valedictorian. He's trying to become the first Clemson basketball player to ever earn a degree in architecture. The team can't practice on Mondays until nighttime because he's in the architecture studio all day.
When I was a student athlete at North Carolina State, the most respected students there were the architecture school. Over the engineers, the Newtown engineers, the lights were never out in that building. They built things.
And Hammonds trying to build a win here for Clemson. Tigers up by four, a timeout taken. Clemson trying to move up into the top of the ACC, trying to get to 6-5. Wake Forest trying to avoid finishing in last place for a second consecutive year for the first time ever. Clemson going for their 20th victory. Boston College, North Carolina, Virginia Tech, and Virginia all up at the top of the league, bunched up in there together. It's still anyone's race. Player of the year wide open, the regular season champion wide open, and Clemson hoping to make some history by winning the 20th game tonight, as it's been quite a while since Clemson has won 20 games. As you can see, during the regular season, it's only been done five previous times. Overall, they've only won 20 games seven times. The 19-5 start, those tied for second best in a 24-game record in school history, trailing only the 86-87 team, which started the year 22-7. But Oliver Purnell hoping to add his name to that list and win his 20th, which will be the fourth different school he's taken to 20 wins in a season.
One of the bitter losses this year was the game in Cameron Indoor Stadium with the clock controversy. Typical Oliver Purnell, who is the current president of the National Association of Basketball Coaches, did not flex his ire at what was turned out to be a controversial and game in which Duke may have had a few extra seconds and pulled out a victory, and he's a touch of class.
Well, Clemson's had a couple of controversial things go against him this year. Georgia Tech also had a problem down there, and he's handled it all with class. Mays has it blocked by Visser. And Wake Forest is threatening again. They just cannot seem to get over the hump, though, as every time they've gotten close, maybe a little bit of a lead, Clemson has responded. Williams, side to side, feeds Visser. Layup is good. He uses every inch of the rim sometimes, doesn't he?
He's got 18 points now. He's 5 for 9 from the field. He needs more touches.
Visser averages 17. Hamilton short on the three this time. And Wake with a chance to tie or take the lead. Visser, reverse layup. We're tied.
Great pass that time by Ishmael Smith. He avoided the contact, the 5'11 jet, and just handed the ball to the big fella and said, finish, big guy.
And the Wake fans can get excited again. And they are fired up. They haven't had a lot to be fired up about this year. It's been a season of struggle. But they're trying to win this home game and get the crowd back in it on Valentine's Day here. Left to play. Lawrence Schull Coliseum seats about 15,000, and it is rocking right now.
You have to keep going back to the last two times these teams have played. It has been OT, with each team winning on its home floor.
Well, the Tigers have been able to respond every time Wake has made a run tonight. And a foul called immediately as Hamilton was trying to get into the lane. Timeout called. We'll do a top 25 update as number one Florida is in trouble. That's coming up.
I'm Martrice.
And I'm Deborah.
We're sisters.
The holes in the wall started out a small little hole.
Ended up huge. Somebody at Home Depot told me,
yeah, you can do this.
They tell you step by step what you need to do.
They're so helpful and knowledgeable and patient.
I wouldn't have been able to finish that project without the people at the Home Depot.
Now my kids say,
my mother did that, but.
At first we was like, Ma, you messing up the house. After the fact, it was really nice.
This was a building that we've made into our home.
We've all seen them. The makeup artist. The dedicated investor. Mr. Change Your Pants While Driving. Multitasking doubles your risk of an accident. Do it a little less, and now Allstate will give you a bonus. Cash off your renewal bill for every 6 months you don't have an accident. Part of your choice auto, only from Allstate. It's time to make the world a better place to drive. That's Allstate, Stan. Are you in good hands?
All the battles you wage, this one is the most demanding. For your fiercest opponent out here is yourself. And your weapons and ammo will decide your fate.
ESPNU brings you college sports 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The passion, the anticipation, the excitement.
Wide open touchdown!
Every season.
This is for three. Count it.
Every reason to watch.
Wisconsin wins!
Every sport all year round. Tomorrow night, Men's Hoops at 7:30. Ohio State looks to stay hot against Penn State. Then at 9, the Blue Devils face ACC powerhouse Boston College. ESPNU, always in season.
Mike Hall with another update for you. It is Florida still in trouble against Alabama. Yamin Coleman floats it up and in, and the lead is 12. By the way, the number two team in the land. There you see Ohio State. There's 11 seconds left. They're holding on to a 4-point lead. If there's a major upset, we'll certainly get back to you, Sam and Bucky.
Great games going on all over the country tonight, including here in Winston-Salem. We're tied at 62 with 3:59 left to play. Wake Forest has not led Clemson since there was 2:20 left to play in the first half, and Clemson's trying to make sure that that streak stays intact.
Wake Forest now in a matchup zone, trying to slow down the Quick Tigers.
Rivers, he's been cold all night.
Boy, he really came off that almost a flick. He did not stay with that shot.
He had 17 against Florida State last week, which is most he had scored in a month.
When you see that jerk back from the shot, it's usually a confidence thing.
Wake Forest again trying to take its first lead of the half. Visser short. And Booker with the rebound.
Oh, the baby boomer with the big chest was not about to be dislodged by the senior that time.
Final 3 minutes of regulation. Who knows how far this one will go. Playing off for Rivers now. Shot clock is a factor. It's down to 5. Rivers is going to have to put it up. In and out. And how about that? Fell right to Williams, and he called a timeout as he was laying on the floor. Yeah. Look what I found.
Oh, my. All of the athletes, Sam, on that floor. All the guys who are skywalkers, and he gets a rebound sitting right on his dump. That's priceless. But the good thing, here it is. Nobody knows what to do. Who's the little guy down there with the ball? Who let the midget in?
Something to be said for laying down on the job, right?
Well, if you can do it sitting down, why not?
What a player. Sitting down, standing up, doesn't matter for Williams. So.
Well, wisely, he did not try to move to get up, whatever, it would have been a walk.
Well, we've got all these great games going on around the country, and one way you can keep up with them is to go to ESPNU.com. It is your source for all things college sports. ESPNU.com, ESPNU, we are college sports.
One thing about that overtime, stunning overtime, Virginia Tech win against Carolina. Proved a couple of things. One, if you got two terrific guards, anything is possible, and Virginia Tech proved that. The second thing is Carolina wins by so much so often. They're not used to being in a one possession game, and that will come with experience. In this league, you're going to get Grossman. Carolina has dominated so many.
Wake Forest found out how good Carolina was last weekend. Williams always put that in the distant memory bank, and he's given Wake Forest the first lead of the half here. An 8-0 Wake Forest run. Wake led with 2:20 left in the first half. Hasn't led since. I make that 2:02 left in the first half, according to that graphic.
Skip Ross's 2-3 matchup has really slowed down and changed the texture of this game.
Oliver Purnell wants to talk it over. Skip Prosser has got his team up by 2. And Visser, the senior there in the huddle, he's been the big difference for Wake Forest, as you might expect, in the second half.
He's done everything. Both ends of the floor, scored, and he can pass.
Well, Visser tonight, here's how he's been in each half. 12 points here in the second half after just 8 in the first.
I'm sure one of the things that was mentioned at half is, I want the big fella to have the ball. He's going to take us home.
Oliver Purnell hoping to break that streak tonight. They've lost 15 straight. Wake Forest just seems to have some magic over the Tigers in this building. 1:45 left to play. The Deacons trying to deny Clemson its 20th win of the year. Hammonds misses the three. Offensive rebound by Booker. He misses, and Mays can't follow it, but he's fouled.
Again for Clemson, no real penetration. It's around the horn, around the horn, around the horn, and then a long three. I think they looked better when they were putting that ball on the floor, getting into the lane and creating.
So it'll be James Mays on the free throw line for Clemson with a chance to tie. 91 seconds left in regulation. Mays tonight, 3 of 4.
Clemson only a 33% shooting team from the bonus field, and they've become satisfied with that. And of course, the free throws at 59% at this point in the game can really hurt you.
Free throw shooting has been a struggle. Oh. Mays makes one of two, Clemson within one.
And here comes that press.
Boy, Hamilton went all the way up on the scorer's table and is able to get back, keep his balance, and get back in play. So Wake Forest up with 120 to play.
If that guy at the scorer's table unbuttons his shirt, his heart's going to fall out. That's one huge, fast human come flying at you.
Smith shouting out instructions from the half-court area. Shot clock under 10. Drum on the penetration, blocked by Booker. Hamilton on the run, one-on-one with Smith, overshoots it. Offensive rebound by Booker, it's blocked by Visser. Mays, no good. And Wake gets it back.
What a flurry of activity. Oliver Purnell in disbelief. His team was scrambling, hustling all over. Look at this, great block, here they come. Good defense that time by Smith, not fouling. What a free-for-all. Power, strength. And the Deacons just hung in there and finally got the ball off the floor.
Visser fouled. He'll go to the line to try to increase this Wake Forest lead. 8 of 11 from the free throw line tonight. Make it 9 of 12. He can still keep it, though, just a one-possession game. But he needs to make this to make Clemson have to make a three to tie. Plenty of time left, though, for both teams. And he makes one of two. So it's a two-point Wake Forest lead, final 40 seconds. Mays going to work. Misses the layup. He's fouled by Visser. A great screen to set that up for Mays, as we'll see it again.
It's like Jim Brown, the running back. Oh, nice pick. Takes Visser right out of the play. I couldn't catch the number there.
It was Booker.
He put a hurting on Visser.
Mays pulls Clemson within one. He can tie it with a free throw here.
With all the quickness and guards on the floor, it's Visser and Mays, two big men, who are dominating play at the end of the game.
Mays calmly makes them both. We're tied at 65.
And no press. Clemson comes back out of that full court press.
Again, they went to overtime twice last year. Are we headed for another? Smith trying to set it up for Wake. They'll play for one shot. It's do or die for Wake Forest. Under 10 to play. Smith dishes off.